This is the Sonoran Desert of central Arizona, not too far from the Phoenix metro area. We're maybe, 30 miles or so southeast of the Phoenix itself. This is the Santan Mountains, and there's a lot of these little uplifts, mountain chains, in the Phoenix metro area. And I thought I'd stop for my little bike right here this morning and explain a little bit about the rocks that we see in these mountains. There's really sort of two parts to the story. There's the story of the rocks themselves and how they formed. And then the second part of the story is how these mountains rose, like how these rocks were actually uplifted. So let's start with the rocks themselves. These rocks are all what we call basement rocks. They're really old, maybe like 1.6 to 1.8 billion years old from the what we call the Proterozoic era. And these rocks are all metamorphic and igneous rocks, intrusive igneous rocks. So these were either magmas that cooled and solidified slowly underground, or else these were metamorphic rocks that were squeezed and heated at depth. So the point is, these rocks formed way down, like miles, maybe tens of miles below the Earth's surface. And now, of course, they're uplifted here at the Earth's surface. So let's look at a couple of these here. Kind of on this knob here, we have these are metamorphic gneisses. And so you can kind of see the banding in the rock here. And what this indicates, this is something called foliation. And when we see the banding in the rock like this, this indicates that the rock was squeezed, that there was a preferential direction. In this case, the rock was squeezed from the left and the right, and the minerals realigned themselves perpendicular to that pressure to form this kind of fabric in the rock. These are mostly gneisses. It's a German word spelled G-N-E-I-S-S. And schists, you can see in some places there's a lot of little shiny particles in the rock. Those are micas. We can also see that there's also some big pods of quartz in here as well, some quartz veins that are kind of cutting through the rock. So this is one type of rock we see here. And if we kind of scramble over here, trying to avoid the cacti, and there's a lot of them, we can maybe see some of the other rocks that form these basement rocks. So we mentioned the metamorphic rocks, these really high grade, high temperature and pressure rocks. A lot of times in these metamorphic rocks, we get minerals that indicate how deep and at what temperatures and pressures the rocks were forming, like some nice little what we call metamorphic indicator minerals. I think in this case, it's probably safe to say these rocks formed probably at least 10 or more miles below the Earth's surface, pretty deep. And the cool story with these metamorphic rocks is they formed at a time when ancient North America was much smaller, and there were smaller chunks of continental crust, small land masses that were colliding with North America at that time. So North America was in the process of growing as little chains of islands or smaller pieces of continents, little microcontinents, came and slammed into the edge of North America. So this was time of North American growth and assembly. Okay, so down here, we've got a big pile of more of these metamorphic rocks, mostly schists. But then you can see a quick change here to these lighter colored rocks. And these are probably a rock a lot of you are familiar with. These are granites. So you can see some of the quartz in there, some of the feldspar, a little bit of biotite, kind of a fine-grained granite. So these granites would have formed as these continents were colliding, the crust was being thickened. And as the crust was being thickened, that meant the rocks at the bottom were being heated. And so we had some of the crust being melted to form magmas. Those magmas then cooled and crystallized to form these granites. So pretty cool, these metamorphic rocks, igneous rocks, the basement rocks. The second part of the story is how did these rocks, which were literally miles below the surface, end up here at the top in the middle of the desert? And to get to that part of the story, we have to actually fast forward quite a bit to maybe about 20 or so million years ago, when most of this part of the Western U.S. was being stretched in an east-west, or in this case, it was more of a southwest-northeast direction. And what that meant was that the rocks near the Earth's surface had to break in response to that stress, so they formed faults, low-angle faults, what we called detachment faults, that actually pulled the younger rocks down and brought these older rocks up to the surface. So the presence of these rocks here indicates that there was a tremendous amount of extension, stretching of the crust that brought these rocks up from below. So pretty fantastic geology here in the desert near Phoenix, Arizona, the Santan Mountains.